one brief announcement that we made last night we'd like to make again. Genesis has just set the all-time three-day gross and attendance record, and we thank you all. As you can probably notice from the lighting system, they've got a new state-of-the-art computerized lighting system, and they've got a few special effects that needs to be dark for them to show it to you. So we're going to be starting the show in about 25 minutes. They play without an intermission, so if you'd like to get up and stretch and do whatever you have to, the show will start in about 25 minutes. Thank you very much.
Thank you. I'm gonna make it. Evening, Portugal. Good evening, Beirut. Good evening, Indonesia. Good evening, the Bay Area in general. Good evening, everybody. Thank you very much for coming. It's Saturday night. It's Saturday night, and that comes before Sunday night, so that's pretty good for us. Comes after Friday night. Comes 2 days after Thursday, 3 days after Wednesday. Quite a long way from Monday. But, well, tonight we're going to play some old shit. And we're going to play some new shit. And we're going to play some shit. No, we're not. I'm just having a look. This is called Dodo. Thank you.
old song. This song is very old. In fact, this tour is almost its 10th anniversary, and so we thought that we would dust off the old 12-string guitar. Dust off the old storybooks. And take you back to a time when Genesis used to play bits, loud bits and quiet bits. Yes, in this song there were lots of loud bits. And there were lots of quiet bits. Loud bits, followed by quiet bits. You have been warned. Anyway, this old song, I thought, deserved an old story, and so I brought out the old storybook. Would you like to hear an old Genesis story? Oh, back there. Right. This, then, is the story of Romeo and Juliet. Nice to see Romeo and Juliet's family in the audience tonight. Romeo, our hero, was 16 years old, and of course he was very horny. Juliet, our heroine, was also 16 years old and very large in the upper regions. One particular day, Romeo telephoned Juliet and asked her to accompany him to a drive-in movie. Juliet, of course, accepted the kind invitation, and before long, Romeo had zipped round in his father's car and had picked Juliet up, and they were on the way to the drive-in. Romeo, frothing at the mouth, no sooner had parked the car at the drive-in than the movie had started, where he proceeded to put his arm around Juliet and started to play with her upper regions. Well, this didn't seem to get anywhere. So he quickly decided to unzip and take off her dress. And following through, he removed her stockings. Finally stopping at her brassiere. Sorry, brassiere. He didn't stop very long. He quickly removed the brassiere. And then Romeo quickly undid his own trousers and took them off. And unfortunately for Romeo, he had to do this himself, you see, because Juliet by this time was, of course, tied up to the steering wheel. Romeo approached Juliet quite quickly, but she cried, said, "No, no, don't come near me with that thing. I won't, I won't." Now Romeo by this time was very highly aroused. And he said, "Juliet, Juliet, you cannot leave me like this." Completely choreographed, you see. Now Juliet took another look at that thing and said, "No, no, please, please, I won't, because I just remembered that supper is ready." Walking across the city,
slowly the shadow walks in front. It crosses hell high and high. And it's, hey babe, you stop like waiting for you. Thank you.
chaos, the battle has led. We climb up the mountain of human flesh to our battle of green grass and green trees. Thank you.
Thank you. We'll be right back. Tunes, but then we're going to ramble. Okay, what I'd like to do now is, we haven't played it for quite a while, and I think some of you might have seen us before. But for those of you who haven't seen us before, I would like to introduce to you the two handsome young men we have accompanying us tonight. Unfortunately, the two handsome young men couldn't be here. So I would like to introduce to you on the guitar, all the way from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, just down the road on the other side of the coast, Mr. Daryl Stammer! Three of us were actually born in San Francisco as well. How can you tell I'm lying? Okay, it's a fake off. This is also another song written in San Francisco when we were here last. And it's all about the city of San Francisco. And
it's all in the cage. I got sunshine in my stomach, like I just lost my biggest scheme. I got sunshine
Thank you. There are these streets in under focus in space. Somehow driving in the stillness to the end. No matter midnight, the night is very bright. There's no whitewash painting. Thank you.
she didn't talk.